I welcome you all. Our today's lecture is based on the course Principle of Electrical Science. In today's lecture, we will discuss about the DC machine. Basically, first of all, before discussing the DC machine, we will see what are the various types of the rotating electrical machines. When we say the different types of rotating electrical machines, we can divide it into the three parts, like the DC machines, we can say AC machines and universal machines. Basically, on the basis of the supply, suppose if we use DC supply, then we can say this is a DC machine. When we use the machine which works on AC supply, we can say this is a AC machine. And if the machine can work on AC supply and as well as on the DC supply, we can call it as a universal machine. Our today's lecture is basically concentrated on the DC machine. We will discuss about the constructional aspects of the DC machine. So we have Dr. V.K. Sharma with us from Jamia Millia Islamia as an expert. So Dr. Sharma, let us know about the what is this DC machine.
Basically, the machines which operate on DC power supplies are termed as DC machines. Now, a machine can operate as a generator or as a motor, and therefore the DC machines are normally DC generators or DC motors. So for that, we have got a slide to present which will tell us how a machine can operate either as a generator or as a motor.
And before starting this, Dr. Sharma, I just want to know that why these machines are so popular, DC machines, and how much these are popular in industry also?
Basically, DC machines offer a special kind of characteristics which is very much common and of use in industries, and therefore the DC motors especially are versatile in their industrial applications. DC generators are not very much popular because DC supply can be nowadays conveniently obtained through conversion of AC to DC through solid state rectifiers. However, DC motor characteristics are not that commonly available through AC motors, and therefore DC motors are still relevant and are being commonly used in industries.
So now we are coming to the basic principles of any machine. So basically, any machine is based on the electromechanical energy conversion. This is an electrical machine. This block is showing the electrical machine. This is the electrical system, mechanical system. So here, in case of electrical machine, the electrical system, it converts the electrical energy to the mechanical energy. Or we can say vice versa. We can say if the mechanical input is given to the, then electrical, we can obtain the electrical output. So basically the flow of, if we say the energy flow of for the generator operation, this is the counter of the energy flow for the motor operation. Now basically any machine, or we can say any rotating electrical machine, this is based on the electromechanical energy conversion. This energy transfer between the electrical and mechanical system is taking place through the coupling medium, and this coupling medium is magnetic field in rotating electrical machines. The two basic phenomena of this machine are, the first is the, when a conductor moves in a magnetic field, voltage is induced in the conductor. The second phenomena is the production of mechanical forces on a current carrying conductors placed in magnetic field. This first principle is based on the Faraday's law. Basically, this is used in case of the any generator action where the conductor moves in a magnetic field and voltage EMF is inducing. The second is the production of the torque. That means the current carrying conductor is placed in a magnetic field, then torque is produced, or we can say the mechanical forces is produced. So this principle is used in any motor. This is the basic principle of working of any electric motor. Now this is the basic relationship for the in the case of the induced EMF. This equation was given by the Faraday's law. Basically, according to Faraday's law, if a conductor is placed in a magnetic field. This is a time varying magnetic field where the conductor, which is having the, suppose a coil is there and which is having the n number of turns, then the induced EMF can be given as the n d phi by dt. Here the term lambda is used, d lambda. Lambda is the flux linkage. This lambda is equal to the n phi. Here the n is constant, so we can take it outside like this. So we can say this is the n d phi. So this is the d lambda by dt, rate of change of flux linkage, is denoted by E. This minus sign is the direction of the induced EMF, which is given by the Lenz law. The second expression for this induced EMF can also be expressed as E is equal to BLV. This is here. The meaning of this is that if the L length of conductor is moving in a magnetic field density of B with a V velocity, then EMF will induced in the conductor, and this is given by E is equal to the BLV. Here the conductor and this magnetic field are right angle to each other. Here we can also use the term sine theta. If this conductor is making some angle of theta with the magnetic field. So this is the basic expression for the induced EMF. This other term, which is very commonly used in machines, generally in the case of the motor, this is the electromagnetic force. Electromagnetic force is F is equal to BIL Newton. This is a very common expression. Here the L length of, if I current carrying conductor, which is of length L, is placed in a magnetic density of B, then it will experience a force which is given by F, and this force is equal to IBL Newton. Basically the direction of this force is given by the Fleming's left hand rule. Now the back EMF and the counter EMF, we will also counter torque, we will discuss in later. Generally this term is used in the case of motor, and this is in case of generator. Now let us come to the basic part of the constructional features of the DC machine. So here the DC machine can be the DC generator, it can be DC motor. Generator, that means the mechanical energy is converted into the electrical energy. When we talk about the motor, means electrical energy converted into the mechanical energy, this is motor, and the mechanical energy is converted into the electrical energy, this is called as generator. So when we talk about the construction of the DC machine, it is basically having the two parts, the stationary part and the rotating part. The stationary part is called as a stator, and the rotating part is called as a rotor. The, in the rotor, generally the armature winding is placed. In stator, generally the field winding is placed. So here the armature, let's look at the slide. So armature is the rotating part, field, this is the stationary part. This is talk about the stator, where the field winding is placed, and in this part is generally stationary in case of the DC machine. The other term you will use, the commutator. This is a device, we will discuss about this. This is a rotating part in DC machine. Brush assembly, this is a stationary part in DC machine. And the other, there may be some electrical connections and the magnetic connection in the case of DC machine. So here the electric circuit of the DC machine comprises terminals of armature, field, commutator, brushes, and armature and field winding, etc. Now let us come to the cross-sectional view of the DC machine. I request Dr. Sharma to describe this.
In this north and south pole, they form one pole pair. This is the armature core. Armature core, the external periphery will have tooth. This is the tooth. This is called as a tooth, and the set of tooth is called as teeth. There is a slot formed here. Between the two tooth, there is a slot formed here. In the slot, there will be placed the armature conductors, which will then form armature winding. So armature core, this is the armature core. Armature core will have on the external periphery armature winding. Inside this there will be a shaft. So shaft will be carrying the armature. On the external part, this is the stationary part. The stationary part will have yoke, and on the internal periphery of the yoke is mounted the poles. Poles carry the field winding. The pole and the yoke, they are made up of cast iron or cast steel. whereas the armature core is made up of silicon steel. Armature windings are made up of copper windings. The electrical circuit is made up of armature winding, field winding, carbon brushes, commutator segments and the machine terminals, the armature terminals. So, this forms the electrical circuit, whereas magnetic circuit is the path through which the flux is set up. So, this is the yoke part, this is magnetic path, then pole shoe, then air gap, then tooth, armature core and then back to the air gap. So, this is the magnetic path. This forms the basic constructional features of the DC machine. Apart from these which are shown here, there are other parts like commutator segment etc. which will be described later.
Dr. Sharma, just from this figure, can we understand the what is the basic principles of DC machines? Then this is the constructional features of the DC machine. This can work as a DC motor and this can work as a DC generator. When we talk about the generator, that means mechanical energy is converted into the electrical energy. How does it work? First, this field winding is basically the DC supply is given to this field winding, and when we give the DC supply to this field winding, the flux will generate and the magnetic field will set up in this air gap. For the working of the as a DC generator, we will we will give the mechanical energy. So this armature is rotated with the help of some prime mover. Here in the slots, the armature conductors are placed, which are called the armature winding. So when this is rotating with the help of the prime mover, then that means from the Faraday's law of electromagnetic induction, what will happen? These conductors will cut the magnetic field set up by this field windings. So here, when this conductor will cut the magnetic field, then the EMF will induced in this conductors. The conductors are not shown here, but just assume the conductors are placed here, and when they are rotating in the magnetic field, the EMF will induced. And that means the mechanical energy is converted into the electrical energy, and this is the principle of the working of this DC machine. Generally, this EMF is of alternating in nature. So, when we are talking about a DC machine, that means it will give, the generator will give the DC supply. So, this supply is changed in the unidirectional, that means the DC form. This EMF is induced, the alternating EMF is converted into the DC with the help of commutator, which we will discuss in the later. Now, come to the motor. How this machine can work as a DC motor? So, you know the basic principle of the motor. Motor means electrical energy is converted into the mechanical energy. Okay. So, here the supply is given to the armature. This is already the work of this field winding is to produce a magnetic field here. This is the coupling field between the electrical and mechanical system. So here in this case, the current is supplied in the armature conductors. Here the armature conductors, and we are giving the electrical energy. That means the current is given to this, and then this current carrying conductor is placed in a magnetic field set up by this field coils. Then what will happen? You know this, the principle. Current carrying conductor is placed in a magnetic field, it will experience a force. That means the torque will develop and this will start rotating. That means when the rotor starts rotating, that means this is the function and this is connected to the shaft. So here, that means the electrical energy is converted into the mechanical energy. So this is the basic principle of any DC motor. Now, Dr. Sharma, I want to know about the material which are used in case of this armature and the yoke part.
Armature part of the DC machine is made up of silicon steel, whereas the yoke part is made up of cast iron or cast steel.
Now let us see the second slide. Here, this is also the cross-sectional view of the DC machine. This is a two-pole DC machine. The previous one was the four pole. Here see, this is the projected poles. This is one pole, this is the second pole. So we can say this is a two pole DC machine. So Dr. Sharma, why do we use these compensating winding and interpoles? What is the role of these?
So we have got these compensating windings and interpoles as has been shown in the figure. This is the carbon brush, we can see. This is the carbon brush, this is the interpole. Interpole is placed between the main poles. Between the main poles is placed the interpoles. Here we have got the compensating windings. Now what happens is that when EMF is being induced in the armature core, so as per Lenz's law, it will oppose the very cause due to which it has been produced, and therefore there is a flux which has been set up by the main poles, and there will be a field which will be produced by the armature windings themselves. So if you see the diagram, we have got the main pole, these are the main pole. So there will be main flux from north pole to south pole, there will be main flux, and then there is the armature winding here. This armature winding will also be carrying currents, so they will set up their own flux. So this main flux and the flux set by the armature winding currents, so that will interact and the main flux will get distorted. Under some conditions the main flux will be distorted, and under some conditions the main flux will be demagnetized, and that is why this is called as demagnetization effect and the cross magnetization effect. And in order to compensate for this demagnetization effect and the cross magnetization effect of the armature flux, there is introduced a winding which is called as the compensating winding. So compensating winding will neutralize the effect of the armature reaction. The combined effect of demagnetization and cross magnetization is termed as armature reaction, and the purpose of compensating winding is to neutralize the effect of armature reaction. That means to make the main flux remain as it is, and it should not be affected by the field which has been set up by the armature conductors. Interpoles have a special purpose apart from neutralizing the effect of armature reaction. Interpoles also help in reducing the reactance voltage at the time of commutation. When the commutation is taking place, then there is a reactance voltage which is developed, and interpoles help in reducing the reactance voltage, which may sometimes cause sparking at the commutator segments.
Dr. Sharma, these interpoles are placed on magnetic neutral axis.
Yes.
Yes. Why?
The reason for placing the interpoles in the magnetic neutral axis is that this is the area, this is the part where the commutators are overlapping. That means they are going from under the north pole to the south pole, or from the south pole to the north pole, and therefore that is the magnetic neutral axis. If you change the direction of current, or if you change the direction of induced EMF in this axis, there will be lesser chances of sparking which may take place, and therefore interpoles are normally placed in the magnetic neutral axis.
Come to the next slide. So basically this armature, we have talked this where the field, this armature windings are placed. So this is the showing the lamination of the armature So this is the one lamination, this is the cross sectional view of this one lamination. So here see, this outer periphery of this lamination is, this is the slotted where the this winding are placed. This is just like a plate. See, the several plates are stacked together to make a complete armature. That means the cylindrical form of the armature. Let us see this. This is the one, this was the previous one was the one lamination. When we connect the, when we stack several laminations together, that means this will form the complete part. This is the armature. See, this is a cylindrical form of the armature. The number of segments are here, number of armature laminations are here, and they just form this slotted portion. See, here we can place the conductors called the armature conductor. Here we can place the conductors, and these conductors can be connected together to form the winding form. So here, and this, see this part, This whole assembly is mounted on the shaft.
This is the armature which is rotating. Now when the armature rotates, anything which rotates will develop some heat, or heat will be produced. So when the armature rotates, heat is produced. In order to dissipate this heat, there are ventilating ducts which are provided. These ventilating ducts are normally provided in larger machines where heat produced is sufficient enough, which requires dissipation. So ventilating ducts are provided, and through this ventilating ducts, air circulation takes place, and through the air, the heat which has been produced will be dissipated to the outside world.
So let us see this part. This is basically, we want to show the commutator segment, the one part. When we talk about the constructional features of the DC machine, there was a one part we have used. This is the commutator. So this is the commutator, and which is mounted on the shaft. See this part. This is the armature, and here the same shaft, the commutator is mounted. This commutator is also made up of several segments. See this. This is the tapered segments are here, and these segments are stacked together to form this kind of thing, just like armature, but these are tapered segments. So this is the one segment, the second segment, and these segments are insulated with each other by using the mica. This mica sheet is used to insulate each segment. So Dr. Sharma, why do we use this commutator?
Basically, what happens is that when you are generating voltage in case of a DC generator, this voltage is having a positive polarity, let us say under north poles. Under the south pole, the generated EMF will be having a negative polarity. So the EMF which is induced in the armature winding will be alternating in nature. In order to convert this EMF induced in the armature to direct current, to direct voltage, to direct EMF. So in order to convert the AC EMF induced to DC, we have to make use of some arrangement, and this mechanical arrangement is the commutator segments. Through commutator segments, the alternating EMF induced in the armature winding is converted into DC.
And what about the brushes?
Brushes are stationary part of DC machines. They pick up the voltage which has been induced in the armature winding through the commutator segments, and they transfer it to the external, to the machine, that means to the terminals of the DC machines. Commutator segments, on the commutator segments rides the carbon brushes. Carbon brushes are pressed through spring on the surface of the commutator, which is rotating in nature, so that there is no sparking which is taking place between the commutator and the brushes.
Let us come to the windings of the DC machine. Basically, the term we use when we talk about the armature winding and the field winding of DC machine, we use turn, we use coil, we use winding. So what is the difference between a turn, coil and winding? There are very small difference between these. So here, the turn is, there are two conductors. This is the one conductor, this is the second conductor, and these are at one end, they are connected by some end connections. So, and the other end is open. This is the one terminal, second terminal. So this is called turn, made up of two conductors. This is one turn. See, if there are number of turns are connected together, see here, one turn, two turn, three turn, that means we have make, this is coil. Okay, now come to the winding. If several coils are connected together in series, here see, this winding, this coil is connected with this coil, similarly other also. So here, when the several coils are connected, then they form winding. So this is a very common terms which are used, but and what is the difference? Now you have must have understood these things. Now in DC machine we generally use two terms, left winding and wave winding. On the basis of the interconnections of the coils, in armature, the connections, on the basis of the coil connections, we say the left winding, and the second is the wave winding. Let us see this, the wave winding picture here. Now I request Dr. Sharma to explain this. What is the wave winding?
So you can see here that a armature winding, this is having two paths. Now wave winding will always have two paths. the whole winding will be connected in two parallel paths. So, there will be a limited current carrying capacity for the wave winding. Whereas, in case of lap winding, the number of parallel paths will be equal to the number of poles. As many as there are number of poles, so will be the number of parallel paths. So, as you can see here, that these are the different turns, and these turns are connected to the commutator segments. These are the commutator segments. Each turn is connected to a commutator segment.
This is the open view.
Yes,
of
this
the
is the rolled view. This is the unrolled view. So, here you have got the carbon brushes. Now, carbon brushes are carrying, collecting the current and sending to the external circuit. Each carbon brush, which is having same polarities, are connected together to form one set, let us say positive, and another set of carbon brushes form the negative. So, one set is positive, one set is negative. So, these are the two terminals which are brought outside the machine to be used as the armature winding terminals.
Now, I would like to thank Dr. Sharma for discussing and sharing a lot of information about DC machine with all of us. Thank you.
Thank you.